Then you are allowed to present your proposal, maybe with your PPT, yeah. And then for you to know that the time for you to present is not more than 15 minutes, because what things the most important here is to listen the review from the reviewer, yeah. And then you also take notes, yeah, what the reviewer asks you to do, to revise your thesis, to make it complete and then to make it better, yeah. Okay, now we will start, yeah. First from the examinee, yeah, Putri. Where is your name? Where is Putri? Where is Putri? Hello, Putri. Wow. Where is the examinee? Mana putrinya ya?
Sepertinya terkeluar, Pak.
Wow. Okay. This is the problem actually, yeah. Because the one who has the project in this meeting seems not stable in the network. Hello, Putri.
Yes, sir.
Make sure that you are in the strong network internet here. Yeah, because you are the host after this. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we start now, Putri.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Your times are not more than 15 minutes. Then time is yours now to present your thesis proposal. Well, yeah. Go on.
Thank you for the opportunity that has been given to me, sir. Good morning, ma'am, Dr. Eleneri Karani, MPD, as my thesis proposal reviewer, and also my first advisor, Sir Iwan Fauji, SPDMA, and second advisor, ma'am, Dr. Natalina Asi, MA. Let me introduce myself. My name is Putrika Oktaria, and my register number is AAA 117067. Today I would like to present my thesis proposal and title, the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at student of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. Chapter 1, introduction. 1.1 Research background. The researcher found as well as difficulties in first, students had difficulty in developing ideas as well as difficulties in expressing opinions and look lacking in vocabulary pronunciation. Second, the students feel embarrassed when the teacher asks them to speak English in front of the class. This is because they are not confident in expressing their opinions. From the reasons, the fact about generally, if students have good self-confidence, they will have good achievement too. Therefore, the researcher is interested to examine the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grade students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. 1.2. Research problem. Based on the background described by the researcher, the research problem of this research is there any correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grades of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya? 1.3, research delimitation. The researcher delimitation this research about the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grade students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. The result of this study only apply to the 10 grade students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. 1.4, research objective. The object objective of this research could be stated as follows: to find out the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grad students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. 1.5, research significance. The researcher will use the study are theoretical and practical significant. The reasons as follow: theoretical significance, the result of this research is expect to be used to enrich theories in the development of language learning and teaching, especially in understanding self-confidence and relate to speaking. Practical significance, benefit for the researcher can be a reference for making related research and will be beneficial information in the teaching and learning process. Benefit for university, it becomes suggestion for university more offer for English study program. So it can be used as a references to the library. Benefit for his teacher, it will be used for them and it will give them information to the research about the contribution and self-confidence on their speaking achievement. Benefit for students, it will make a student have a good self-confidence and speaking achievement. Chapter 2, literature review. 2.1, concept and theory. There are each concept and theory. The first one, self-confidence. The factor of self-confidence, indicators of self-confidence, speaking, the elements of speaking, types of speaking, aspect of speaking achievement, the effect of high and low self-confidence on speaking performance. 2.2, previous study. Research conduct by Riva Silvia Sari, 2020, entitled The Correlation Between Self-Confidence and Their Speaking Skill at the 12th Grade of SMA N2 Bukit Tinggi. Second, research conduct by Nutin Nasih, 2019, entitled The Correlation Between Self-Confidence and Speaking Performance of the Fourth Semester Students of English Department of University in Islam Malang. And the last one is research conduct by Rizky Mauli Audina, 2021, entitled The Correlation Between Self-Confidence of the Undergraduate EFL Students and Their Speaking Achievement. Chapter 3, Research Method. 3.1, Design of Research. In conducting this research, correlational research design will use to find out the correlation between variables and explain the and interpret the results that may appear. The design description, variable X, students' self-confidence, and variable Y, students' speaking achievement. 3.2, population and sample. Population. In this research, the population is the 10 grad students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. In taking the sample, the researcher is going to use purposive sampling. Therefore, the researcher choose 10 MIPA 2 grad students that consists of about 38 students. 3.3, assumption. In this research, the researcher assumes that every student has different degree of self-confidence. The second is every student has different achievement in learning speaking. And the last one, self-confidence is an important factor in speaking achievement. 3.4, hypothesis. Null hypothesis, there is no significant correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grad students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. And alternative hypothesis, there are is a significant correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grade students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. 3.5, definition of operational variable. First, in this study, the independent variable is self-confidence. The second is, in this study, the independent variable is speaking achievement. 3.6, technique of data collecting. In this research, the researcher prepared of questionnaires to measure student self-confidence and to identify the student speaking scores. The first questionnaire, self-confidence. In this study, the researcher distribute questionnaires to the 10 grades of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. The questionnaire consists of 30 items with a Likert scale. The second speaking test. In this study, they obtain student speaking achievement. A short speech monologue test will be used. The topic of talking about self consists of greeting, name, birthday, hobby, and education. 3.7, technique of data analysis. Questionnaire data analysis. In this questionnaire, the Likert scale is used as a variable measure. Speaking test. In the analysis of the speaking test, speaking achievement result are categories based on the assessment system and categories as follow: pronunciation, grammar, vocabulary, fluency, and comprehension. The last one is correlation analysis. In this research, the data will be processed quantitative in order to find out whether there is a significant correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10 grade student of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. The data will analyze by using SPSS 22 person. 3.8, research instrument. First, content validity questionnaire. In this questionnaire, direction and values, 5 items, motivation, 5 items, emotional stability, 5 items, a positive mindset, 5 items, self-awareness, 5 items, and essence of purpose, 5 items. A total of 30 items will use. Construct validity questionnaire. From each questionnaire, there are 6 indicators. Are direction and values, motivation, emotional stability, a positive mindset, self-awareness, and essence of purpose. Next, content validity speaking test. In this study, the instrumentation with the topic of talking about self will be based on the curriculum design of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya from class 10 MIPA 2. From the speaking test, there are 5 indicators of topic talking about self consists of greeting, name, birthday, hobby, and education. Construct validity speaking test. In this study, the content validity of the instrumentation was based on the curriculum design and syllabus of SMA N 3 Palangkaraya for 10 grades in the 2022 to 2023 academic year. Therefore, the researcher used the topic of talking about yourself as an example of the text in the teaching and learning process. There are 5 indicators used in the speaking test: are pronunciation, grammar, vocabulary, fluency, and comprehension. reliability of instrument. First, reliability questionnaire. In this study, Cronbach's alpha will be used to test the reliability of questionnaire. And the second, reliability speaking test. In this study, the researcher will use person to measure the consistency of the speaking test. And the last, instrument tryout. It will use to first find out the whether the instrument is correct or able to be used for collecting the data needed. Second, evaluate whether the instruction is clear and understandable for the students. Third, determine the time allocation. And the last one, gather evidence to support the instrument's validity and reliability. That's all my thesis proposal presentation. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Oke, okay. Thank you, Putrika. Semangat sekali sepertinya ya.
Iya, okay. Pak.
Yes, and then now the main season of our seminar, yeah, proposal, thesis proposal seminar, to hear the review from our reviewer, yeah, the honor Ibu Elaneri Kanani, yeah, and then. And for you also to know, yeah, Putrika, you should take notes for what she gives you. The notes to revise your proposal, and then also to make it better than what you have already written. Now that's the most important thing for you to do. Yeah.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Ibu Elaneri. Now time's yours, Ibu. Yeah. For you to review this student's proposal.
Okay, thank you very much, Pak Iwan, as the first advisor of Putrika Oktaria's thesis proposal. Well, first of all, I would like to congratulate Putrika because you are brave enough to propose a different title than the previous thesis proposal the student have. So it is very interesting to see this correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement at the 10th grade students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. Well, let's see carefully the title of this thesis proposal. Correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement. A pool. Correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement of
SMA
of student achievement, right?
Yes.
So you want to explore the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement of students, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's see a little mistake here. Correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement of. You see there, at this app, you at. Put at here. Why yes. Don't you change it of? At with all. Speaking achievement of the 10th grade students. Okay, got it?
Yes, yes ma'am.
Okay, so does it make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Doesn't matter, later you can discuss it with your advisors, yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
But it's very important for you to know this. Okay, Putrika, can I have you to pronounce or to say or to mention the following? Person and percent. Oktaria, please. Please say. Person.
Person.
Just follow me. Person.
Person.
Percent.
Percent.
Apa bedanya person dengan percent?
Beda pronunciation-nya.
Ya, apa artinya person tadi apa?
Person.
When I person say person. Orang. Okay, percent.
Person, presentasi.
Percent. So just follow me. Percent. Repeat up to me. Percent.
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 Nah, beda kan persen dengan persen. Tadi yang mengucapkan ya mana yang persen, ya mana yang persen. Ini jadi sedikit bingung. This is closely related with the topic that you are proposed this morning, yeah. So it is very important to pay attention about how to pronounce standardized English pronunciation for a particular similar or minimum or similar words, yeah, or whatever. Okay. Yes, now let's begin from chapter one. Well, it is very interesting when you elaborate your discussion in this part, I mean chapter one, but unfortunately I didn't find at all about the information concerning English curriculum that explain about speaking skill or the speaking activity or instructional material related to speaking English in that particular class. So I missed that, Putrika, yeah?
Yes,
so why So why don't you add or elaborate information concerning English curriculum, particularly the explanation that tells us about speaking instructional material related to speaking English for grade 10 for SMA, yeah? So I think you need to elaborate that information and try to relate it with the speaking achievement that the student need to meet in a particular semester, in a particular class. And the second point is, I see from the title that you proposed today, or this morning, is self-confidence and speaking achievement. And again, I didn't find the clarification. Okay, you can argue because the buku pedoman doesn't state the clarification of teacher. But I think it is very important for you as a researcher to clarify a specific or a particular term that help the readers understand the idea that you convey. Okay, for example, self-confidence. Apa sih self-confidence itu? Yang you maksudkan self-confidence ini apa di sini? Can you explain it to me?
Percayaan diri, ma'am.
Ya, apa itu? Percaya diri itu apa? Bisa dijelaskan secara operasional. Self-confidence dalam speaking English itu apa? Itu yang sebetulnya perlu dijelaskan pada clarification of key terms, khususnya dalam konteks penelitian, judul penelitianmu ini. Self-confidence. Kalau singer kan self-confidence juga, dia teriak-teriak, itu kan singer. Sekarang ini kan spoken, at least speaker of English. Jadi konteksnya adalah self-confidence sebagai speaker of English. Gitu. Beda kan? Yeah. Dengan yang self-confidence ibu-ibu itu mengurus anak, gitu kan? Yeah. Atau ibu-ibu, apa ya? Okay, forget it. Self-confidence seorang singer itu berbeda dengan self-confidence dari seorang speaker of English, gitu. Yang you masukkan di sini kan self confidence dari speaker of English, gitu. Itu yang menurut ibu it's very important for you to state, to explain, to clarify this term. Itu ya, Putrika.
Yeah, ma'am.
Do you agree with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Itu yang di samping ada yang ini ya, ada penggembiranya, yes yes tadi ya, kedengaran dari sini. Okay, yeah. Next chapter 2. Oh ya, sebentar. Still chapter 1. Chapter 1. Okay, research problem. Research problemnya adalah, is there any correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement of 10 grade students at or of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya? Adakah korelasi antara self-confidence, speaking achievement, self-confidence dan speaking achievement gitu ya? Dari siswa yeah. SMA kelas 3, dari siswa kelas 10 SMA Negeri 3.
Yeah.
Ini bunyinya ini kayak the effect of. Is there any effect? Is there any significant effect? Seperti itu ya. But it's okay. It's okay. Later you can prove that. And your objective is to explore. Daripada to find out, mending lebih keren kata di situ ganti aja to explore. Ya kan? To explore the correlation between self-confidence and speaking achievement of the 10 grade students. Okay, so now let's jump up. Let's go on to the next page, chapter 2. Okay, I'm glad that you are able to elaborate so many sources to help you to refer to these theories and also previous research that has been conducted by the previous researcher. And I'm sorry to say, it seems to me that you need to discuss it based on standardized English paragraph writing. Yeah, why I say so? Because, for example, here, chapter 2, literature review. This chapter contains many theories related to this research. Apa sih mau ini, Putri? Chapter 2 ini kan review.
Yeah,
literature review. Poinnya itu apa? Main poinnya apa, Putri?
Penjelasan dari self-confidence dengan speaking achievement-nya.
Oke, berarti tugasmu di sini adalah mereview. Apa sih artinya mereview? Apa sinonim word dari review? Dok, saya sudah ngomong, nggak tahu tenggorokan. Yuk, apa? Review itu sinonimnya apa? Tahu sinonim tidak? Sinonim itu apa?
Persamaan.
Ya, review itu sinonimnya apa?
Simulate.
Simulate? Apa simulate? Bingung ibu dengarnya. Hah? Ya, ini kedengaran betul, Pak Iwan. Could you close your screen, sorry? Ayo, jangan banyak ketawa dong. Penjelasannya ibu perlukan. Ketawanya nanti.
Iya, ma'am.
Ibu sih yakin aja, you self-confidence. Pokoknya senyum-senyum terus nih. Ya, apa review itu apa? In this chapter content, ibu ini bagaimana bacanya? In this chapter content, many theories related to this research. Yang mana yang subjek, yang mana yang predikat ini? Nggak jelas ibu bingung melihat kalimat ini yang dengan literature review ini. Oke, kalau you bingung, itu menjadi perhatian. Tolong diperbaiki nanti. Jelaskan.
Baik, ma'am.
Okay, review, literature review.
Excuse me, Putri. Could you close your screen share now, Putri?
Ini nah, yang ini nih, dia tutup dulu. Chapter 1 introduction itu.
Sebentar.
Tutup dulu, close. PowerPoint ini nah.
Iya, ma'am.
Stop share.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Nah, sekarang ibu lanjut. Okay, Pak Iwan, excuse me. Please allow me to speak bahasa Indonesia.
It's okay.
It seems to be a lot of things that I need to clarify.
Everything on the stage is yours, Ibu.
Okay, thank you very much, Pak Iwan. Okay, sekarang lanjut. Nah, pada bab kedua ini, chapter 2, you need to explain many theories that you think those are closely related with yours. I mean, the thesis proposal that you proposed this morning. So these theories can support your idea. Okay? So that is the importance of reviewing references in chapter 2. So first, you explain about self-confidence. It's okay. But it seems to me, yeah, I put some notes over here in order to help you to to rearrange, to restructure all the sentences or the paragraph in order to make the idea that you want to share to me as a reader is clear, yeah, or very clear. So that you need to also summarize every quotation, every theorist that you quote, yeah. So in that case, I can see the main point that you want to share, yeah, based on the quotation that you have. And here on page 8, it is very interesting to see 2.1.3 indicators of self-confidence. Once again, Putri. I'm sorry to say there is no topic sentence over here, what you want to say, what is the main point that you want to discuss here, but I can grasp the idea that you want to share here. That is, you want to say, you want to expose indicators of self-confidence that consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, I think here, if I'm not mistaken. So 10 components here, 10 aspects, I mean. And later, you pick up some of these indicators in order to develop, in order to design questionnaire, okay? But later we are going to discuss about that. But remember, these are indicators of self-confidence, okay? Now let's see the next chapter. Let's jump up to the next chapter. This is very important, I think. And the main discussion is here, research method. Since you are going to apply correlational research design, it means that you need to elaborate or to explain about variables. Here you mention there are two variables. The first one is variables of self-confidence, and the second one is variable of speaking achievement. Again, yeah, it seems to me that you need to restructure this paragraph in order to expose your idea clearer, yeah, so that it's easier for me and also for other readers to understand the idea that you share. Okay, figure 3.1, research design X. I don't understand what you mean by X. And then there is an arrow over there, and then there is a Y in the box. You didn't explain it all about this figure, yeah? Because it doesn't tell anything about the figure that you want to share. Mm-hmm. Kan di sini ada X, X itu student self-confidence. I don't know why ada student speaking achievement. Tolong diingat bahwa dalam korelasi itu dia balance. Jadi tidak ada efek A terhadap B. Ya, tolong diperhatikan itu. Sehingga figure ini tolong ditinjau ulang. Itu kan kayaknya X itu berpengaruh kepada Y kalau you buat arrow-nya seperti itu. Sementara korelasi itu, paradigma korelasi itu, prinsip korelasi itu sama. Artinya balance itu ya. Jadi tidak ada A mempengaruhi B atau B mempengaruhi A. No. Itu yang berbeda sekali dan itu yang bisa miskonsep nantinya. Tolong dipahami ya.
Baik, ma'am.
Oke, itu catatan untukmu. Berikut lagi. Population and sample. Population of this research is the 10 grade student of SMA Negeri di Palangkaraya. Populasinya semua kelas 10 SMA. Lalu, you mengambil kemudian sampelnya menurut Pak Subiono ini menggunakan teknik purposive sampling. Itu artinya you menerapkan apa yang disebut dengan non-probability sampling. Tapi kamu tidak menjelaskannya di sini. Tidak semua orang tahu itu. Kalau you tidak menjelaskannya, ada probability. Jadi dia semua punya kesempatan. Tapi ini kayaknya tidak punya kesempatan khusus kelas ini saja. Lalu you menganut non-probability sampling. Itu tidak ada dijelaskan di sini. Tolong dijelaskan bahwa itu
kelas,
kenapa diambil non-probability sampling, alasannya tidak ada di sini, itu perlu diklarify. Sehingga you kemudian select, ini chose-nya apa ini? Therefore, the researcher chose IPA 2 grade student and consists of, membingungkan juga ini, consists of about, apa maksudmu? Consists of aja. Kan consists itu selalu of temannya, gandengannya. Consists of 38 students. Okay. Jadi you memilih 38 ini dengan ini. Okay. It understandable if you share the reason behind this process of selection. But here, I didn't find any reason at all. You cuma mengatakan, menurut Sugiono, purposive sampling adalah ini. Tolong diperhatikan dulu, pengambilan sampel itu enggak seenak-enak kita. Loh. Harus ada ininya juga, reason-nya. Ya Putri ya?
Baik, ma'am.
Itu weakness-nya dari sampling ini. Dan ini sangat berbahaya pada saat you meng-apply ini nanti pada saat, untuk melakukan pengambilan data karena pada saat pengambilan datanya kalau samplingnya keliru maka biasnya berpengaruh sekali. Lanjut, di sini ada assumption. Okay, I don't care about the assumption, tetapi yang saya kritisi adalah yang ABC. Kalau paragraf itu tidak ada ABC, yang ada adalah first, second, third atau 1, 2, and 3. Begitu, itu yang paragraf, writing paragraph, standardized English writing paragraph. Jadi tolong dicek ulang ini nih. Now we come to very important part, hypothesis. Nah ini dia, hypothesis of this study are proposed in the form of new and alternative hypothesis as below, gitu ya. There is no significant correlation. Gini ya, paradigmanya sekali lagi penelitian korelasi itu berbeda dengan komparatif atau berbeda juga dengan penelitian eksperimental ya. Pada saat you mendesain hipotesis ini ya, maka you berpikir bahwa self confidence itu sama pentingnya, seimbang nih antara achievement dan self confidence. Maka seharusnya bunyi yang saya tahu ya, yang ibu pelajari ini.
Baik, ma'am.
Maka bunyi hipotesisnya the higher, gitu ya. The higher self-confidence the student have, the better speaking achievement they obtain atau they get. Harusnya kan begitu. Itu yang alternatif hipotesisnya. Putri ya.
Baik, nah, ma'am.
Bukan kalau ini bunyinya sudah lain, ini effect of ini tadi, terus there is no significant effect of, ini kan there is no significant correlation. Sementara ini kan harus jelas nih, the higher self-confidence, kan gitu kita berpikir. Maka semakin tinggi juga, semakin baik juga speaking achievement-nya. Lalu bagaimana dengan null hypothesis-nya? Ya iyalah, kalau the lower, the worse. Kan gitu dia. Sehingga, kalau you tetap mengatakan di sini, kan tidak jelas ini, there is no significance, itu masih terlalu umum. Tetapi kalau you sudah specify seperti ini tadi, yang saya sebutkan tadi, the higher, the better, the lower, the worse, itu kan jelas barangnya. Yang itulah yang akan diuji pada testing hypothesis testing nanti. Terbukti tidak? Kan hypothesis testing itu menguji kebenaran kesimpulan sementara yang kita state dalam bentuk hypothesis ini. Misalnya begini tadi, the higher self-confidence the student have, the better speaking achievement they get. Itu ya. Itu alternatifnya saja. Saya beri satu contoh alternatif hypothesis-nya. Artinya terbukti tidak bahwa mereka higher self-confidence atau lower? Apakah nanti akan terbukti bahwa kalau the lower self-confidence, the worst speaking achievement they obtain misalnya. Terbukti tidak? Nah itulah yang akan dilakukan pada uji hipotesis, hypothesis testing, Putrika.
Baik, ma'am.
Oke, lanjut. Lanjut ya.
Baik, ma'am.
Sekarang teknik mana tadi? Teknik data collection. You mau cari data apa di sini yang you perlukan?
Data dari self-confidence dengan speaking achievement-nya, Mem.
Data self-confidence siapa?
Dari students.
Ya, student self-confidence. Datanya kan student self-confidence. Jadi, bukan data tentang self-confidence, tapi student self-confidence. Itu datanya. Dengan cara apa data itu dikumpulkan?
Dengan cara... dikumpulkannya dengan cara tes di sini menggunakan
bujur. Bujur pelan-pelan, Bu.
Baik,
itu yang berbisik di sebelah itu yang lebih semangat daripada yang seminar ini nih. Ya coba ulang lagi. Data tentang student self confidence diperoleh menggunakan apa, dikumpulkan menggunakan apa, dijaring menggunakan apa, alatnya, instrumennya,
kuesioner.
Oke, stop. Itu data tentang student self-confidence. Sekarang student apa namanya tadi?
Speaking achievement.
Student speaking achievement dapat dari mana? Atau student score-nya ini apa? Student speaking score-nya dari mana?
Dari dengan cara, apa? Dengan cara speaking test menggunakan monolog, Mem. Terus diberikan, diberikan topik sesuai dengan silabus yang berisi dari greeting. Name.
Ya, bagus. Kan berarti kurikulum lagi kan Ibu bilang tadi yang tidak ada di bagian chapter 1 itu. Sekarang you sekarang stay di sini Ibu happy. I'm glad that you now confidence to explain to me that you are going to do speaking test in the form of monologue. Jadi bukan dialog kan? Di situ dia makanya di delimitation itu harusnya you mengatakan bahwa ini speaking achievement atau speaking testnya nanti adalah tentang monolog, fokusnya bukan dialog. Sementara di silabus itu dialog juga ada interaktif. Kalau monolog ini kan cuma apa ya istilahnya, ya monolog, dia cuma ngomong sendiri.
Iya, Mem.
Pertanyaan Ibu, apakah ini kemudian berkaitan dengan penjelasanmu di bab 1 tadi bahwa speaking itu kemampuan berkomunikasi itu dimulai dengan speaking, harusnya mulai dari situ. Bahwa di kurikulum bahasa Inggris untuk SMA khususnya untuk speaking skill itu dikembangkan melalui proses monolog dulu, melatih mereka dengan pronunciation, share ideas-nya clearly, gitu kan, fluency-nya. Mulai dari situ dulu step-nya, baru naik ke interactive dialog. Gitu loh, harusnya penjelasannya bukan bulat di communication, udah segampang itu loh komunikasi. Dosen-dosen aja, emang you kira bisa bahasa Inggris, terus orang bisa interaktif komunikasi. No, itu melalui proses, dan itu ada triknya, ada tipsnya. Ya, yang perlu dilatih berulang-ulang, ya, continuously. Lalu, pertanyaan Ibu sekarang berkaitan dengan kuesioner. Kuesioner itu you elaborate dengan bagaimana? Questioner tadi itu you gunakan untuk menjaring data tentang student self-confidence, kan? Lalu questioner itu berisi 30 item yang you susun berdasarkan skala Likert. Ada setuju, skala setuju, and so on. Ada standardized, ada kriterianya di situ, ya. Ada scale-nya. Lalu indikator-indikatornya itu menyangkut berapa aspek indikator di situ?
Ada 6, Mem.
Ini teori siapa yang you rujuk? Merujuk teori siapa?
Dari Arikunto 2000.
Enggak ada. Arikunto itu bicara mengenai urusan self-confidence. Enggak ada. Kalau Journey itu masih bisa nyambung. Pernah membaca buku Journey?
Belum,
itu motivation, Mem. Differences itu si Journey itu masih ada di situ. Masih ada relevansinya buku Journey itu. Ibu punya bukunya. Tapi you cari sendiri aja di internet tuh banyak kok referensi tentang hal itu. Arikunto ini tidak ada menjelaskan tentang self-confidence. Nonsense ini. You merujuk, benar-benar merujuk punya Arikunto itu nggak ada. Ini cara mengembangkan kuesioner aja Arikunto yang 2010 ini. Jadi yang menurut Ibu harusnya you merujuk kepada teori di bab 2 tadi. Itu nah. Yang Ibu baca sih sebetulnya you merujuk kepada teorinya si Burton dan Plates 2016 ini. 2006. Yang 10 poin tadi itu lah. Halaman 8 dan 9. Putri.
Iya,
Mas. Nah, kenapa si Arikunto yang you rujuk nggak ada relevansinya sama sekali? itulah gunanya review of literature itu mendukung, menguatkan, menopang scaffold idemu itu dengan ide ahli-ahli, expert. Nah, dalam hal ini, Burton and Plates ini mempropose indicator of self-confidence yang you elaborate nantinya dalam bentuk questionnaire yang sekian item itu tadi. Dan ini memang nyambung. Ada direction and value, ada apa tadi. Tetapi ibu cuma menemukan 6 dari 10 itu. Kemana yang 4-nya? Yuk, Putri, ke kue jijay. Pak, tete. Yuk, cap naik, mener.
Belum saya masukkan, Nan.
Yuk, kalau tidak dimasukkan, dijelaskan karena dong. Alasanmu kenapa tidak memasukkan emotional stability, positive mindset, self-awareness. You cuma masukkan a sense of purpose. You cuma memasukkan motivation di sini. Sementara si itu tadi, si Burton dan Plates itu tadi mempropos 10 item. Coba, eagerness to develop flexibility in behavior, self-awareness, positive mindset. Nah, emotional stability. Kenapa mereka-mereka itu you abaikan, tidak you masukkan? Tentu ada alasannya, dijelaskan di situ, ada health and energy, ada willingness to take risk. Tapi you cuma ambil a sense of purpose. Kenapa? Jelaskan.
Baik, ma'am.
Ya, memang tidak harus 10 ini diambil, tetapi jelaskan kenapa cuma diambil yang sekian biji itu menjadi dasarnya untuk mengembangkan kuesioner tersebut. Oke, okay. Ya Putri.
Baik, ma'am.
Jelas. Baik. Jelas. Sekarang kita lihat nih. Sudah ada you siapkan di sini. Lampiran halaman 34, 35, 36, 37. Ibu menghargai karena kamu disiplin memberikan nomor pada setiap halaman ini sehingga gampang kita melacaknya. Coba nih. Mulai dari halaman 35. Self confidence. Nomor satu ya. I'm active in English class because English is fun. Lalu jawabannya di sebelah itu SSS, KSTS, STS. Ibu tanya dulu, S itu apa? SS itu apa?
SS saya setuju, kemudian S saya sangat setuju.
Pak, membujur-bujur. Kok SS saya setuju, saya sangat setuju, yang mana? Ya, ulang.
Yang S-nya saya sangat setuju, kemudian S.
Yang double, ini kan ada double S, ada single double. S, gitu. Nah, ya. Yang mana ini? Ini apa penjelasanmu? Ayo ulang. SS itu apa?
Saya setuju, sangat nah, setuju.
Pembujur Rika Putri, Mimias Au. SM itu kan saya sangat setuju. Gak ada sayanya. Ngapain buku saya di situ? Saya gak ikut.
Iya memang.
SS itu sangat setuju. S-nya lagi setuju.
Setuju.
KS itu apa?
Kurang setuju.
Terus TS?
Tidak setuju.
Kalau STS?
Sangat tidak setuju.
Versi bahasa Inggrisnya apa? Kalau sangat sangat tidak setuju.
I'm not.
Nggak ada I'm not di situ. Kamu di aja.
Iya.
Sangat setuju apa? Sangat setuju apa bahasa Inggris anunya versi bahasa Inggrisnya?
Sangat setuju.
Kan? Agree, disagree, kan itu.
Iya, Mam.
Kau tuh. Nanti lah. Agree, disagree dan apa pokoknya itu ulang ke situ ya.
Iya, Mam.
Dan versi bahasa Indonesia, versi bahasa Inggris dong.
Baik, Mam.
Oke lah bahasa Indonesianya ada tapi versi bahasa Inggrisnya juga harus. Oke, lanjut ya. Tuh. Jadi si Ari Kunto tuh coret aja. Elak ke kerimen Banjaru ibu. Ketahuan ibu bakas breakout. Speaking test. Nah, ini juga di akar karuan penjelasan speaking test tuh. Speaking test yang you maksud di sini tadi jelaskan tentang monolog. So, it is to me that you need to explain that speaking test in this case is to apa? To explain that the student will perform, speaking performance dalam bentuk apa? Monolog. Ya. Topiknya tentang apa? Berdasarkan kurikulum tentang self apa tadi?
Self-confidence.
Talking about apa?
Self.
Ini banyak di sini ada talking about self, ada greeting, name, yeah, birthday, hobby.
Di...
Ya.
Yeah.
Jadi sesuaikan dengan kurikulumnya. Oke. Okay. Ya, Ibu setuju. It's very, it's amazing that you are going to ask your student, the students to record their voice using voice recorder and later share it using WhatsApp application. Good. It's very interesting. Bagus nih. You sudah menggunakan IT di sini. Bagus. Ya, boleh dilanjutkan. Ibu sangat setuju.
Baik,
lanjut. Ma'am. Lanjut sekarang kepada teknik of data analysis. Questioner. Apa sih maksudnya ini? Questioner data analysis maksudmu apa? Teknik of data analysis. Harusnya teknik of data analysis itu dijelaskan. Bahwa yang dimaksud dengan teknik analisis itu di sini. Analisis itu akan dilakukan untuk menganalisis satu. First, questioner. Second, speaking. Apa tadi? Speaking test.
Speaking test.
Ya, itu harusnya. Ini nggak jelas nih. Tiba-tiba fundi hulang di situ. Ibu sampai bingung melihatnya. Nah, kamu memang jatuh cinta sekali sama Sugiono dan Rikunto nih kayaknya. Di sini Sugiono lagi. Lakert lah itu tadi. Oke, okay, enggak masalah. Sekarang yang you masukkan dengan ini mulai table 3.3 scale Likert. Likert scale atau scale Likert? Ibu enggak ngerti yang mau apa ini. Table 3. Ah, Lara itu lah. Yuk diperbaiki lah.
Baik, ma'am.
Scale Likert. mahasiswa. Terus diambil dari Sugiono. Wah. Terus maksimum skornya 150. Itu dari mana sih 150 itu?
Dari skor, contoh skornya.
Iya, Ibu tahu aja yang skor itu dari mana hitung-hitungannya sehingga dapat yang 150. Kan kuesionernya kan 30. Yang... 30 item. Terus dari mana tuh maksimum skornya 150 ini ceritanya bagaimana? Ayo, ayo. Yang mana? Dikali apa?
Dari...
Mana? Jelaskan dong.
Dari ininya, Mem. Dari jawab.
Ya, dari jawaban. Jawaban yang mana? Jawaban siswa. Dari jawaban siswa. Dari jawaban siswa yang mana?
Yang mengenai dari self confidence memang.
Iya, iya, yang mana? Itu di situ kan ada skor soal positif. Iya. 5 4 3 2 1. Terus ada skor soal negatif 1 2 3 4 5. Yang tahu positif negatifnya itu you aja, Ibu belum lacak itu instrumennya karena belum masih dalam diangan-anganmu saja kan. Iya, di belakang tadi itu cuma contoh aja.
Iya, Mam.
Ayo. Jadi yang dikali itu yang mana? Yang 30 tadi dikali yang mana? Yang terus dapat 150 ini?
30 dikali dengan interval level.
Apanya yang interval? Apanya interval?
Sebentar. Maximum score.
You harus tahu ini. Jangan mengambil sembarangan dan merujuk-rujuk umbo-umbo hoi ini. Jangan.
Baik.
Mana? Ayo jelaskan dong.
Jadi untuk skornya itu mem.
Ya kan logikanya gini aja. Soal item di questioner itu kan 30 soal. 30 ya. Item. 30 ini dikali 5 itu yang 5 yang mana? Yang dimasukkan itu 5 itu. Ibu paham aja ini. Cuma Ibu mau mencek. To recheck. Ibu paham tidak ini? Jangan cuma menuliskan di sini. 150 itu dihasilkan dari 30 kali 5. 5 yang mana ini?
5 yang...
5 yang mana?
Bentar ya, Mam.
Nah,
dari skor yang...
Ayo.
Dari self-confidence-nya, Mam. Yang...
Ya, self-confidence yang mana?
Yang SS tadi, Mem.
Berarti itu self-confidence yang skor soal positif. Kalau jawabannya itu S semua, sangat setuju. Misalnya kan ada statement di situ positif, ada statementnya negatif. ada ya statement negatif. Kalau negatif maka dia nilainya 1 walaupun sangat setuju. Tapi kalau statementnya positif, dia sangat setuju, maka skornya 5. Itu hati-hati di situ. Jangan-jangan nanti yang juga si yang sangat setuju positif pro 1 terbalik dia. Jadi sekarang berarti ini skor positif yang sangat setuju, 5 di situ, hasilnya 50, itunya maksimum skornya. Sekarang ibu tanya, acquisition skor itu apa sih?
Acquisition skor itu...
Maksudnya, oh, bahasa Indonesia apa sih? Acquisition skor itu apa maksudnya?
Acquisition...
Kamu nih translate sembarangan, nih nah, kayak student value, ini maksudmu apa? Student value. Student skor gitu kenapa sih? Oh, student value... Yeah. Di atas tuh kamu bilang value semua, score, di bawah tiba-tiba value. Bagaimana ini? Coba. Maximum score, acquisition score. Maksudmu tuh nilai mutlak gitu ya?
Iya.
Iya, kok lihat orang sebelah sih? Lihat itu dong. Jadi kalau acquisition score, ibu gak ngerti nih translation-nya apa nih. Terserah aja nanti.
Konsultasi iya, baik, mem.
Sama dengan student value. Kenapa di atasnya score, maximum score, acquisition score, tiba-tiba di bawahnya student value. Lah macam-macam ikan nampak kari istilah peta. Nah, Putri.
Baik, ma'am.
Nah, sekarang kategori level. Interval, level of student self-confidence. Artinya, you nanti akan mengumpulkan data-data. Itu data-data itu ada data diskrit namanya. Ada data kontinum. Pernah mendengar itu?
Belum, ma'am.
Bebes enggak, ya? Indah dia bebes deh ya. Yo, ya ibu bukan malah bebesnya, ibu cuma mulai sekalian mengajarnya.
Baik, ma'am.
Data itu ada dua jenis, ada data diskrit, ada data kontinum. Punyamu ini masuk data yang mana? Sekarang kalau si data apa tadi, si data diskrit tadi itu dibagi lagi. Ya data diskrit itu dibagi lagi. Ada data nominal. Kalau data kontinum itu ada data ordinal, ada data interval, ada data rasio. Korelasi itu harus tahu itu. Datanya kalau kontinum, datanya klasifikasi datanya itu, maka dia ada ordinal, ada interval, ada rasio. Itu loh datanya. Punya ini data apa? Bertanya dulu. Yang ada ini level high enough, middle, low, very low.
Interval level.
Dari mana kamu tahu interval? Bukan interval ini. Bukan interval itu. Datamu ini data ordinal, tingkatan, tingkat itu. Nah, high. Kan tingkatan nih, very high kan tingkatnya. Yo. Bukan interval, itu ordinal, tingkatan. Terus ya, nah kalau datamu itu data ordinal, maka nanti kaitannya dengan rumus yang you gunakan untuk hipotesis testingnya, Putri. Ya, tolong diperhatikan itu. Oke, lanjut. Sekarang speaking test. Lanjut ke speaking test. Speaking test ini, mereka kan perform ya, speaking performance kan, lalu itu nanti di record, itu lagi nanti dinilai. Yang menilai siapa?
Yang menilainya saya dan guru ini.
Guru siapa? Guru siapa?
Guru bahasa Inggris.
Oke, ya sebutkan ya bahwa di situ ada 1, 2, ada 2 orang asesornya. Sebutkan saja di situ ya, supaya apa gunanya sampai 2 orang? Kenapa perlu 2?
Karena menurut dari buku
Ibu ngajar assessment. Ya, yuk dulu Ibu sudah ngajar kalian assessment. Kenapa harus 2? Supaya apa? Supaya apa? Supaya apa? Ayo Putri, cepatlah. Ingat kan ibu ngajari assessment evaluation. Lupa lagi, sudah lulus lupa lagi. Supaya reliabilitasnya apa?
Supaya akurat nih.
Ya gitulah. Kan kalau you sendiri nanti transubjektif, kalau gurunya sendiri juga mungkin transubjektif. Jadi supaya tidak unsur terlalu supaya objektif penilaiannya, maka harus ada 2 orang, Mbak. Itu nanti interwriter atau apa namanya di situ ya. Okay. Sekali lagi Ibu, kalau melihat dari data yang New Jaring ini, kayaknya data ordinal, bukan data interval, sehingga itu berdampak kepada rumus yang akan digunakan untuk hipotesis, melakukan hipotesis testing. Putri ya, ingat ya. You bisa menggunakan product moment, tapi kalau itu interval, ini kan tidak interval, ini ordinal. Ranking 1, ranking 2 itu kan interval, itu order, tingkatan. Nah, sama dengan ini juga speaking. Aduh, hai, kau tengah menduar yang Harris tuh. Kenapa enggak di Harmel, kenapa enggak di Brown yang you pakai ini. Senam aja Harris dah. 1974, you aja belum lahir, kayak apa? Ibu aja sudah enggak pakai si Harris ini, sudah. Ganti yang lain dong, Brown kayak gitu. Kan Brown tuh yang terkenal untuk assessment.
Iya,
atau Bachman. Bachman tuh terkenal juga untuk assessment. Orangnya masih hidup sampai sekarang. Banyak tuh, bisa di-googling aja, dapat. Terus, sekarang dibalik ke 3.6, classifying of scores of the student. Nah, itu kan, coba nih. Excellent, very good, good, poor, very poor. Ini kan ordinal. Sekarang, pertanyaan Ibu. Nilai-nilai ini nanti, apakah nilai individual atau mean score?
Individual.
Wah, nggak bisa dong korelasinya ke individual. Ini kan kelas, bukan individual. Kalau kelas itu kan grup. Mean score dong. Nah, mean score itu baru nanti excellent. Apakah very good, rata-ratanya apakah good. Itu yang hubungannya dengan hipotesis Ibu bilang tadi. The better, the higher, the better. The lower, the worse. Itu loh hubungannya dengan hipotesis tadi yang perlu you uji melalui kegiatan hipotesis testing nanti. You gunakan SPSS, rumusnya yang mana. Hati-hati, bukan product moment, tetapi spearman rank. Nah,
ya.
Itu loh. Saya sedikit cerewet pagi ini lah. Jangan kamu
dengar Ibu. Gak apa-apa memang.
Oke. Terus yang terakhir itu adalah kegiatan bukan correlation analysis, Putri, tetapi namanya adalah hypothesis testing. Diganti itulah, diganti Put. Mumpung ingat.
Baik, Mam.
Jadi 7.3.3 itu adalah hypothesis testing, bukan correlation analysis. Apanya yang dianalisis lagi? You cuma menguji, memastikan menggunakan rumus itu, data yang you peroleh tadi, you masukkan ke dalam rumus menggunakan aplikasi SPSS 22, ngecek keluarlah apakah alternatif hipotesisnya itu pada signifikasi 0.0.0.5 lebih kecil atau lebih besar, maka terlihat di situ rejected or accepted. Gitu ceritanya, Put. Jelas, Put?
Jelas, Ma'am.
Oke, saya memberikan penekanan kepada apa namanya ini tadi, instrumen yang akan you kembangkan. Oke, kalau ini contoh saja saya setuju. Tetapi kalau ini akan dijadikan sebagai instrumen untuk menjaring tentang student self confidence, saya belum setuju. Kenapa? Karena di sini you merujuk mengadaptasi dari Nofilia Ritchie. Si Nofilia Ritchie ini siapakah dia? Ibu tidak tahu, karena di referensi tidak ada nama orang ini. Nah, apakah ini memang mengacu kepada 6 indikator self-confidence yang di set oleh Burton dan Platts tadi 2006 itu atau tidak? Kalau dia iya, silakan. Tetapi kalau tidak, berarti you mengambil punya orang yang tidak jelas rujukannya. Dan itu tidak valid. Putri ya?
Baik.
Nah, ini harus di try out. Bukti try outnya apa nanti? Harus dilampirkan juga try out instrumen ini. Ya. Jadi itu saran dari Ibu. Dan terakhir adalah references. References itu penting sekali. Saya mencatat di sini banyak sekali referensi-referensi yang you sembunyikan. Dan ini mencurigakan bagi Ibu. Kenapa disembunyikan? Artinya tidak muncul di sini. Di bagian dalam proposal ini tampak muncul nama-nama orang tersebut. Tetapi kemudian di daftar referensinya tidak ada. Makanya Ibu terheran-heran. What's going on? Nah, di situ. Termasuk tundan-tundan itu tadi, yang sahabat saya itu, tidak muncul juga namanya di sini. Tuh, jatuh Naranto Widote. Nah, keberatan lah Ibu. Kalau Pak Iwan jelas di sini ada kan?
Iya,
Mam. Gitu. Yang lainnya tolong semuanya dicek ulang. Baik, itu Pak Iwan, itu apa namanya kritisasi saya, kritik-kritik saya terhadap proposal proposal Putrika, tapi so far you have done your job, yeah. You have proposed, you have wrote this proposal based on the standardized buku pedoman, and it's good, yeah. So great job, but it seems to me that still weakness here and there. So it means that you have to revise that based on the standardized thesis proposal writing. Okay, Pak Iwan Fauzi. Terima kasih banyak, saya sudah berpanjang lebar dan panjang-panjang. Saya kembalikan kembali kepada moderator Pak Iwan Fauzi.
Okay, thank you Bu Elan. Sorry I close my camera because I'm on the way to take my children here.
So, okay.
To take my daughter. Okay, thank you Bu Elan. And then for you to know Putri that there are so many things that you should do. You should revise after this because your imperfections of your proposal what Bu Elan say is you should make many revisions on your thesis proposal. I'm well driving now, it's okay. Okay. Yes, okay, Ibu Elan, yeah, thank you for your review, yeah. And then welcome. I hope Putri, maybe 2 weeks, yeah. Enough for you,
yes,
Putri.
Sir.
Yes, yes, sir. You should do more, yeah. Maybe 24 hours a day, I don't know, yeah, that's your choice to revise your thesis proposal because the sooner the better for you, yeah. Okay, and then is our meeting recording, Putri?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's better for you to rewind and then to replay the recording. Yeah, because there are so many things that Bu Elan asked you to revise. Yeah. Okay, thank you, Bu Elan, for your revision.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you for your time to review this student's proposal. And then
my
see
pleasure.
You many
my
times.
Pleasure.
Yeah. This is a very valuable for Putri. Yeah, thank you. I now I end the sessions. Yeah, mm-hmm. And see you in any times. Yeah, see
yes,
you,
sir.
Putri.
See you. Okay. Sir, thank you.
Thank you, everyone. See you. Take care.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay.
Good morning.
Morning, everyone.
Good morning.